Good morning, students. Today we are going to deal with our chapter 2, classical genetics. Okay, in this chapter we are going to look hereditary and variation, then Mendelism, monohybrid probe, dihybrid probe, and interaction of genes, that is intragenic gene interactions and intergenic interactions, polygenic inheritance and extra chromosomal inheritance. So these are the portions we are dealing in this chapter. Okay, so today we can go with the basics. What are the basics related to genetics? Before that, what is genetics? Anyone know what is genetics? Yeah, genetics is the study of inherited characters. Genetics is the study of hereditary or study of hereditary or inheritance. So inheritance means transmission of characters from one generation to another. Transmission of characters from one generation to another. Okay. Genetics are of different types. Classical genetics, molecular genetics, quantum genetics and
quantitative
genetics. Okay. So in this chapter we are dealing with transmission genetics or classical genetics. Okay. Classical genetics otherwise called as transmission genetics. Okay, so we discuss study of hereditary. What is hereditary? Hereditary is the transmission of characters from one generation to another. Transmission of characters from one generation to another or parents to offspring. So the character transmission from parents to offspring is hereditary. Then what is variation? Variation means change in a particular character, change in a particular character of species in a population. Change in the character of individuals of a species in a population is called variation. Okay. Hereditary means certain characters which are transferred from one generation to another. Then variation means change in those characters. Change in those characters. Okay. You all know that some character of us are similar to our parents. Some of our characters are similar or somewhat almost alike to our parents. Okay, this is due to the transfer of certain things from one generation to another. Do you know what is the thing that is transferring from one generation to another? Reuben, tell me. Gene, correct. Genes are the factors or the genetic thing that is transferring from one generation to another. Okay. So, do you know what is the difference between gene, chromosome, DNA? Consider this is a cell. Center of the cell is nucleus. Center of the cell is nucleus. Nucleus is nothing. It is the condensed form of chromosome. Nucleus is the condensed form of chromosome. Condensed form of chromosomes. What are chromosomes? Chromosomes are nothing. It is the linear DNA that is arranged in compressed form or condensed form. The linear DNA, it is almost high in their length. So it is not suitable to arrange in a cell. So what it done is it will coiled or it will condense so that it can occupy in a cell. Okay, so in chromosome, DNA are present. Okay, so what is gene? What is gene or what are genes? Genes are certain position which is present in a DNA or gene. Certain position or certain segments in a DNA or gene which are responsible for the expression of certain character. Which are responsible for the expression of certain character. Okay, you understand what is the difference between chromosome, DNA and gene. Okay, Then the variation are of two types. Variation are of two types: discontinuous variation and continuous variation. Continuous and discontinuous variation. Continuous variation and discontinuous variation. Discontinuous variation, also known as qualitative inheritance. Discontinuous variation, also known as qualitative inheritance. Qualitative inheritance. Continuous is quantitative inheritance. Quantitative inheritance. Okay. Discontinuous variation. The variation is only a limited. In a population, the variation is only in a limited form. That is discontinuous variation. And it is mainly determined by the inheritance characters. Discontinuous is only by inheritance characters or inheritance factors. There is no role for the environmental factors. There is no role for environmental factors. There is no role for environment. But in continuous, it is the combination of inheritance and environment. It is a combination of inheritance and environment. So discontinuous variation is also known as qualitative inheritance. The variation is of only limited in a population. And it is determined by inheritance factors, and there is no role for the environmental factors. Example, style length in primula and plant height of garden pea. Style length in primula and plant height of garden pea. You have to notice the examples. Okay, one mark question may ask for examination. Then continuous variation. Continuous variation is also known as quantitative inheritance. The variation is determined, or the variation is brought by the combination of both inheritance factors as well as environment. Environment as well as inheritance factors or genes have equal importance for the formation or the for the production of the variation. Okay, then so you understand what is the difference between continuous and discontinuous variation. Now, importance of variation. What are the importance? The variation may be beneficial as well as harmful. Sometimes the variation may be beneficial in the ecosystem or the environment. Sometimes the variation may be harmful for the individual. Okay, so first one, the variation makes some individuals better fitted in the struggle for existence. So the variation makes some individuals better fitted in the struggle for existence. Okay, so due to variation, certain individuals can survive in that environment. Second one, they help the individuals to adapt themselves to the changing environment. They help the individuals to adapt themselves to the changing environment. We know environment are changing. They are not stable. They will change. But it will take so many years to change an environment, isn't it? So to adapt in that changing environment, this variation may help. Then it provides the genetic material for natural selection. It provides the genetic material for natural selection. And also variation allow breeders to improve better yield, quicker growth, increased resistance and lesser input. So by brought variation, we can produce better yield. We can produce better varieties. Okay. Then they constitute the raw material for evolution. Raw material for evolution. So these are the differences between continuous and discontinuous variation and the importance of variation. Okay. Now, the word genetics was coined by Bateson. Bateson in 1906. The word genetics was coined by the scientist Bateson in 1906. But in 1880s already, the work related to genetics or the work related to the inheritance of behavior is started. Do you know who started this work? Yes, Gregor Johann Mendel. So we say the father of genetics is Gregor Johann Mendel. He born on 22nd July 1822 and he died in the year 1866. Okay. He done his experiment in the plant Pisum sativum, garden pea. Pisum sativum, garden pea. He done his experiment in the pea plant or garden pea, Pisum sativum. Scientific name of garden pea is Pisum sativum. He done 6 years of his work on Pisum sativum. He done 6 years of work. Just think how long he take to inference such valuable information by doing the experiment in Pisum sativum. He takes 6 years. Okay. Then he died in 1866. He died in 1866. Okay. But in his time, the Mendel is not recognized by other scientists. The Mendel was not recognized by other scientists. Why? Because he was a Austrian monk. He was a Austrian monk. Austrian monk means he was a priest, church priest. And he was a mathematician too. Okay. But he studied physics, chemistry, biology and everything. And he was worked in a school for many years. Okay, so he done all his experiments and he made so many valuable inferences. But other scientists never recognized him because he is a mathematician. So other scientists think that what a mathematician know about plants or know about biology. So they refused Mendel. And also he didn't publish the work properly. He didn't publish his work properly. He published his work in a local journal. You know what are journals? Journals are magazines in which scientific works are published. Journals are magazines in which scientific works are published. Okay. So there are three types of journals. International journals, national journals and local journals. Local journal means if we publish a work in local journals, it is only circulated in a small area. But national journal means it will circulate within a nation. Then international journals means it will circulate within a international or within whole world it is circulating. Okay, so what happened means the Mendel who published his work in a local journal. Okay, so only small area of scientists or small area of people will know about Mendel work. And second and the third failure is in his era, you know, Charles Darwin who proposed the theory of evolution. The Darwin theory was established in his era. The Darwin theory was proposed and established in his era. So almost all the scientists are following Darwinism. All are focusing in Darwinism. None of them recognize Mendel work. Okay, so after his death, 16 years ago, three scientists who rediscovered Mendelism or Mendel work, first was Karl Korenz, Hugo G. Virus, then Erich von Schirmack. Okay, so today we are studying about all the genetic which is related to Mendel. It was by the contribution of these three scientists, Karl Korenz, Hugo G. Virus and Erich von Schirmack. Okay, so this is about the discovery of genetics and about the father of genetics, Mendel. Now, how the Mendel was successful in his experiment? How? What makes him successful in his experiment? First one, I already said he was a mathematician. So he used mathematical formulas and statistical method. He used mathematical formula and statistical method for his biological experiment. Okay, so it will make him more success. It will make the data more authentic. Okay, then he followed the scientific rules and formula strictly. He followed the principles rules strictly, so he came to a good inferences. Then he take large samples. Okay, large samples means he done so many experiments. Nearly he done 24,034 crosses of pea plants he done for his experiment. Okay, so he takes large samples for his experiment and he keep accurate and detailed records. He get accurate and detailed records. Always Mendel used pure breed lines. We will discuss what are pure breed lines in the terminologies. Mendel always used pure breed lines. Okay, so these are the things which made Mendel success in his experiment. Okay, then he take the plants Pisum sativum or garden pea. There are several different characters which showing by Pisum sativum. So Mendel done his experiments in garden pea, that is Pisum sativum. So several character or features of garden pea which make Mendel successful. First one, it is an annual plant. Okay, it has large flower. And they are bisexual in condition. And have short lifespan. And easy to cross pollinate. Okay. So garden pea or Pisum sativum, it is an annual plant. And it has large flower. So we can easily done experiments using Pisum sativum. Then they are bisexual. You know what are bisexual? Bisexual means both andrecium and gynecium is present in one flower. That is bisexual. And it has short lifespan. Okay, so their reproductive cycle will be completed within a 2 to 3 weeks. Then self-pollinate. The plant which can self-pollinate. You know what are self-pollinate? Self-pollinate means the pollen grains from the stamen will dust it on the stigma of the ovary or stigma of the gynecium of same flower. Okay, that is self-pollination. And easy to cross-pollinate. Why? Because it is a large flower and it is bisexual flower. So we can easily cross-pollinate it. Okay, so these are the features of Pisum sativum or garden pea which make Mendel successful in his biological experiment. Then, what are emasculation? You know what is emasculation? Emasculation is the removal of anthers. Okay, so before going to do the experiments, Mendel remove the anthers from the plant, anthers from the flower. Okay, why? Because to avoid self-pollination. Mendel remove the anthers from the flower. Mendel take seven different characters of pea. What are the seven different characters? Plant height, flower position, Flower color. Pot shape. Pot color. Seed shape. Seed color. So, plant height, flower position, flower color, pod shape, pod color, seed shape and seed color are the seven different characters which is used by Mendel for his biological experiments. So, in plant height, there are two different contrasting characters. Plant height has two different contrasting characters. What are they?
Tall
and dwarf. Tall, dwarf are the two contrasting characters of plant height. Flower position, axial, terminal. Axial and terminal. Flower color, purple, white. Pod shape, pod color, seed shape, finally seed color, yellow, green. These are the different contrasting characters of the seven character which is taken by Mendel. Okay, all the character which are controlled by certain genes. All the character which are controlled by certain genes. So, plant height is controlled by the gene LE. Flower position is controlled by the gene FA. Flower color is controlled by A. Pod shape is controlled by V. Pod color is controlled by GP. Seed shape is controlled by R. And seed color is controlled by I. Certain genes which is responsible for the expression of these characters. Okay. So these are the genes which is responsible for the expression of certain okay. You people understand? You people understand? Okay. Now we can discuss about so how many characters Mendel take for his experiment? Seven different characters are taken by Mendel. These seven different characters are present in seven different chromosomes. That is the most seven different chromosomes. These seven characters are present in seven different chromosomes, which helps Mendel the most to success his experiment. Okay, so you have to by heart these seven different characters and what are the contrasting characters and genes which is responsible for expression of those characters. Okay, now we can study about certain terminologies which is related to the Mendelism. Terminologies which is related to the Mendelism. Terminologies related to Mendelism. Okay, first terminology, genes. Genes. Genes is the word which is coined by Johansson. Johansson, who is coined the word genes. Genes are the functional unit of inheritance. Functional unit of inheritance. That is, genes are transferring from one generation to another. But Mendel didn't know the factors that genes are transferring from one generation to another. He called those things as factors. Mendel's know something is transferring from one generation to another, but he unable to know genes are the things that is transferring from one generation to another. So he named them as factors. Factors are transferring from one generation to another. Okay. Then first is genes. Second one, alleles. Second term, alleles. Alleles are the alternative forms of genes. Alternative forms of genes. Alternative forms of genes are alleles. Understood? Okay. Then, so alternative forms means if you consider plant height. If you consider plant height, two alternative forms of plant height are there. One is tall and another one is dwarf. Or if you take the flower color, purple is one alternative form and other white is the second alternative form. So you understand what are alternative forms. Okay. So we will express alleles with the help of certain alphabetical letters or alphabetical letters. Capital T, small t. Then homozygous and heterozygous. Homozygous and heterozygous. Homozygous, heterozygous. What are homozygous? Homozygous means an organism having same type of alleles. An organism having same type of alleles are homozygous, whereas heterozygous means different alleles. An organism having different alleles for a character. Hey, example, capital T or small t. These are homozygous, same type of alleles, TT. Both are capital or both are small. That is homozygous. Then heterozygous means different, capital T, small t. They are two type of alleles which is present for an organism, that is heterozygous. Okay, then what are dominant and recessive? What are dominant and recessive? Dominant means a character which is always expressed in a cross. Character which are always expressed in a cross, that is dominant. Example, capital T, capital T. So capital T is dominant. So we can call this as homozygous dominant. Homozygous dominant. Okay, homozygous dominant. Then recessive. What are recessive? Recessive are certain characters which are not always expressed in cross. They are silenced in F1 generation. So recessive means character which are not expressed in all cross, not always expressed. It will express but not always express. It will be silenced. Okay. So example, small t. These are homozygous recessive. Why? Because both the alleles are same. So homozygous recessive. Homozygous recessive. Okay. Then what are phenotype and genotype? Phenotype and genotype. Phenotype means the physical appearance. Phenotype means the physical appearance and genotype means the genetic makeup. So genes are the functional unit, alleles are the alternative forms of genes. Homozygous means an organism having same type of alleles. Heterozygous means an organism having different types of alleles. Dominant means the character which are always expressed in a cross. Recessive means the character which are not always expressed in a cross. Then phenotype means the physical appearance or observable character of a organism. And genotype means the genetic makeup or genetic constitution which make the character. These are the terms. Okay. These are the terms which is main terms which is used in genetics. Then some other terms also there. Cross. You know what are cross? cross. Cross means breeding between two plants. Breeding between two plants. Breeding between two plants that are cross. Okay, then punnet square. You know what are punnet square? Punnet square is the graphical representation of the gamete. Graphical representation of gamete for the next generation. Okay, for example, this is the punnet square of F1 generation of a monohybrid cross. Okay, so punnet square is the graphical representation of gametes which helps for the formation of next generation. That is punnet square. Punnet is the scientist who discovered this graphical representation. So that's why punnet square. Then what are cell fins? Selfing. Selfing means nothing. It is self-pollination. Selfing means self-pollination. After obtaining the first generation, we will allow the first generation offspring to selfing. That's why it is called as selfing or self-pollination. Two plants from the same generation are crossed. That is selfing. Then what are pure line? Pure breed line. Pure breed line. For all the crows, we have to take pure breed lines. Pure breed line means organism having same alleles. Example, capital T, small t. That is homozygous. Homozygous alleles are pure breed lines. So we have to cross the pure breed lines for obtaining the F1 generation. Okay. Then monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross and trihybrid cross. Mono, di and trihybrid. Monohybrid means, we will discuss these later, just we will mention what the term implies. Monohybrid cross means we are taking only one character of the individuals at a time. If we are taking two individuals for the crossing, we are only taking one character of those individuals. Then dihybrid means we are taking two character of a individuals. We are taking two character of the individuals. That is dihybrid. Trihybrid means we are taking three character of the individuals. We are taking three character of the individuals for the cross. So these are monohybrid, dihybrid, trihybrid crosses. So these are the terms which is related to Mendelism. Terms which is related to Mendelism. In the beginning, we discussed that certain genes are responsible for the expression of characters. Just like LE, the gene LE is responsible for the expression of height. Okay, expression of height, LE, which is responsible for the plant height. Gene which is responsible for plant height. Just like that, gene A, which is responsible for the flower color. Gene A, which is responsible for the flower color of the pea. Some scientists who discovered the action or the mechanism which is behind the expression of the purple color or the white color in the flower. Some scientists, they discovered the mechanism behind this expression or the regulating of flower color. So we know the two color is purple and
white.
Purple and white. Purple is the dominant character. White is the recessive character. Purple is the dominant character and white is the recessive character. Okay, what they found that a gene which is responsible for the expression of purple color is gene A. Gene A is responsible for the expression of the flower color purple. what the gene A is done, gene A which codes for, gene A codes for a protein, gene A which codes for the formation or synthesis of a protein. Okay, that protein will act as a transcription factor. Transcription factor for the synthesis of anthocyanin. Anthocyanin pigment. So what they will discover? Gene A, the gene which is responsible for the flower color, gene A, it codes for a protein. That protein which is acts as a transcription factor. Transcription factor means those are responsible for the synthesis of another protein. Transcription factor means those are protein which is responsible for the synthesis of other biological molecule. It may be protein, nucleic acid, whatever it is. Okay, then this protein acts as a transcription factor for the synthesis of anthocyanin pigment. Anthocyanin pigment is a pigment which is responsible for the expression of purple color. We know chlorophyll pigment which gives green color. Just like that, anthocyanin pigment which gives us purple color. Okay, so when a plant having gene A, the flower color will be purple. This is a mechanism which is happening. So what they done is, they take some normal gene A. They isolated some gene A and they injected or they transferred those gene A into white petal. Two types of flower, purple color flower and white color flower. In purple color flower, gene A is present. Okay, so they want to know what happened in the white colored flower. Okay, white color flower. So they isolate gene A from the purple color flower. They isolate gene A from the purple flower. Then they inject or transferred with the help of gene gun. You will be studying what is gene gun in your third chapter. Third or fourth chapter. Okay, so with the help of gene gun, they will transfer the gene A into cells of white flower, that is white petal, flower petal, into the petal. Okay, some cells will receive the gene A. Some cells of the white flower receive this gene A and started synthesizing anthocyanin, and the some region will become purple. Some region of the white flower became purpled. So they came to know that, okay, so gene A is the responsible for the synthesis of purple flower or purple color. Okay, so they isolated genes from the white flower also. But the sequences, they are comparing both from purple flower and white flower. One nucleotide is changed in the white flower. You didn't understand? This is purple flower. They also isolate gene from the white flower. Same. Gene A. But what happened is, it's the nucleotide sequence or the nitrogenous base pair. One is changed in the gene A. So it is a mutant gene. It produces a mutant protein. These proteins never act as a transcription factor for the synthesis of anthocyanin. So that the flower appeared as white. Understood? Okay. So what are the things we studied in today class? First, we discuss about what are genetics and what are the difference between hereditary and variation, then different type of variation, discontinuous variation, continuous variation. Okay, so child length, then span, height are the examples for discontinuous variation. Human height and human skin color are the examples for continuous variation. Then some importance of variation. Then the discovery about the genetics, that is father of genetics, Gregor Johann Mendel. Then certain terminologies which is related to genetics. Then the seven different characters of our pea plant, Physum sativum. So these are the things we studied in this chapter or today. Okay. In next class, we will discuss what are monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross, then dihybrid test cross. Next class, we will discuss these three portions. Okay. So from this area, we just go to a recap. From this area, we will just go to a recap. Take your note. Recap. So first question, gene responsible for anthocyanin pigment synthesis in purple flower of a pea plant. Gene responsible for anthocyanin pigment synthesis in purple flower of a pea plant. Second question, organism having two different alleles in a gene. This condition is called organism having two different alleles in a gene. This condition is called. Third question, alternative forms of a gene. Alternative forms of a gene is called. Fourth question, functional unit of inheritance. Functional unit of inheritance. Fifth question, human height is an example of which type of variation? Human height is an example for which type of variation? First one answer, GA. The gene responsible for anthocyanin pigment synthesis in purple flower of a pea plant is GA. Second one, organism having two different alleles in a gene. This condition is called heterozygous. Third one, alternative forms of a gene is alleles. Fourth question, functional unit of inheritance is called genes. Fifth question, human height is an example of which type of variation? Continuous variation. So, these are up to today's